Hi everybody, welcome to Sharon from Vivid Days. I am going to be giving this silicone mold a go. I saw that on Amazon, I thought I wanted to have a little go, so why not? Let's test drive it. The link will be in my description. You might wonder what's under my tin foil. I don't think aliens are coming, but it's my Lazy Susan, and it's just so I can turn it around in one area. No, it's in focus. And have some fun. I recommend you get a Lazy Susan. I'm going to be working with a couple of different colours that I normally work with. Hashtag disclaimer, except my casting craft opaque. I'm going to be using Colour Cottage, Sapphire Blue, Seaside Blue and White. And just have a little fun and sort of see what we can do. But within those, I'm going to add a little bit of sparkle. And I've got a little bit of glitter left from Just For You. And there is some blue. One's a blue glitter. One's a chunky light blue. And the other is a chunky iridescent white. So I'm just going to add a little sparkle in there. So I'm not going for realism. Just want a little bit of spark, a little bit of fun. I've mixed up 200 mils of resin. This is craft resin, the last of it. And I'm imagining I should have some left over. However, the mold is quite deep, so I could need more, but I'll let you know at the end of it. However, if it doesn't reach the top, I'm going to flood it with another coat and add a little bit more wave action at the top. So I will put my mask on, you will see my process, and we'll come and review at the end. Happy days! Hi, Sharon from Vivid Days. We are here for review time. We're going to demold this silicone mold, because that's what you do with molds. And we're going to see, what are the shape like? Do I like this composition? Definitely different to what I originally thought I was going to do. It was a abstract version of Ocean, but I just wanted to work with these colours and the glitter. But without further ado, let's unmold those. But just in case you didn't know, tin foil, it's very good for you just peeling off your little bits of resin. And it's expensive and you don't want to sort of do that, but FYI, something you could use over and over. Anyway, I'm shy and I'm digressing. Let's unmold these. So these seem to be coming out very nice. Our first shape, so from the front, it has got a nice little fan to it. Edges, good. And at the back, very shimmery. Ooh, it's like a mermaid tail. Anyway, number one. Number two. Okay, come away beautifully. Nice sparkle. Do love that tones. And the mermaid side. Glitter City. I'll come back and maybe I'll just take them out. So, from a mold point of view, they've come out shiny. I have no issues with that. I can use that over and over again. So that's a thumbs up from me. I will put the link into my description. It looks like it's made by an independent person. But yay. Anyway, back to these parts. Lovely. The back and the sides. Actually, pretty nice mold, if I'm being honest. There we go. And what I might have to do is just come and dome one of them there. The rest are fine. But just where it can't have been quite level, it's pushed it away a little bit. But it's not a biggie. There we go. So they are some very nice coasters. Imagine that. I've got my cup of tea. There we go. Right, what I am going to do now is show you some pens that I've got, and I am going to come and put silver around the edge of the inside. So I'm looking at these paint pens, and this has got, it's water-based, fine tips, gold and silver. You can use them on glass, ceramics, porcelain, wood, rubber, metal, fabric, stone, paper and more. So I'm going to have a little go and see if I put this on my edge, what is that going to look like? So I've come in with my paint pen and I've gone around the edges. I've decided to leave the outside blue, but I love the silver edges. Now it does show up your imperfections with your air bubbles. You may choose to just leave them as they are, but I think that it just frames them beautifully. So you can see that shiny edge. The paint's got to dry, but you can see it reflecting on there. But yeah, I quite like these. They're interesting. I want to come back and explore this mold with different colors, but yeah, I think it's a good result. What do you think? Remember, thumbs up, subscribe, share, comments are always welcome. Remember to visit my Facebook page to show and join the group to showcase your art, and remember to visit my Facebook, Etsy and Redbubble store if you want to purchase any of my art. But a cool project. The mold worked really well. Definitely was abstract, but The results are rewarding and so many possibilities, and I love these pens. All right, see you in the next video. Until then, have a wonderful day and keep safe, and thank you for all your support. Much love. Bye.